Rage at Rolling Stone magazine after editors of its new issue put an accused killer and terrorist on the cover. And here it is. That's the surviving suspect in the Boston Marathon bombing. The caption calls him a bright kid with a charming future who somehow became a monster. Critics are accusing Rolling Stone of glamorizing someone they claim is a monster. Their biggest issue? The choice of the photo on the cover.
That's not just a photo of Joe Carr. That's a very flattering, sympathetic photo that apparently, based on the pre-release information, goes with a story that is, sympathetic towards him as a victim.
Well, remember, the feds say this is the guy who, along with his brother, killed three people, wounded some 260, some of whom had their legs blown right off. The brothers are also accused of killing a police officer. Investigators say Jokhar Tsarnaev also scrawled anti-American messages in that boat before they captured him there, remember, and referred to his victims as collateral damage. Trace Gallagher with the news live this afternoon. Critics say this cover is very similar to past rock stars.
Yeah, and to show you what they're talking about, Shep, we actually built a graphic. We put the cover of the Tsarnaev Rolling Stone cover in between covers of Jim Morrison and past pictures of Bob Dylan. You can see for yourself how very close they resemble each other, which is kind of causing a lot of the outrage. The stories you said build is a heartbreaking account of that charming young man. Well, critics say if they wanted a heartbreaking account, they should have put a victim on the cover. And Rolling Stone has finally responded, saying the issue, quoting here, falls within the traditions of journalism and Rolling Stone's longstanding commitment to serious and thoughtful coverage of the most important political and cultural issues of our day. The fact that Jokhar Tsarnaev is young and in the same age group as many of our readers makes it all the more important for us to examine the complexities of this issue and gain a more complete understanding of how a tragedy like this happens. That statement from Rolling Stone, by the way, just came down, Chip, like 20, 25 minutes ago.
And still lots of outrage in Boston, Trace.
And not really just the people in and around the Boston area, but you've got companies now that are from the New England area that are doing their own boycotts. CVS, the drugstore, has pulled the issue off the shelves, saying, and I'm quoting here, as a company with deep roots in New England and a strong presence in Boston, we believe this is the right decision out of respect for the victims of the attack and their loved ones. Tedeschi Foods, which has hundreds of stores in and around New England, says, quote, Tedeschi Food Shop supports the need to share the news with everyone, but cannot support actions that serve to glorify the evil actions of anyone. Music and terrorism do not mix. They have also pulled the issue. Here's Massachusetts Governor Deval Patrick. Listen.
I think they're hearing from everybody. I understand, I haven't read, but I understand the substance of the article is not objectionable. It's apparently pretty good reporting. But the cover is out of taste, I think.
And by the way, the controversial issue hits the newsstands in early August. Chapter.
Trace Gallagher, thank you, sir.